Let's take a look at AirSync, ViewSonic's all-in-one casting solution. The reason I mean it's all-in-one is it really does everything you want with any device on any network. So what you need to do to get started is find the AirSync app on your ViewSonic display. We'll go ahead and open it here. Now this screen is your home screen. It's gonna show you everything you need to start casting your device. I have a few devices with me. I have my phone, my laptop, as well as a tablet. You'll notice here that it says go to this website to get started. Essentially, there's two ways you can cast your device. You can do it through the web, or you can do it through the AirSync app, which requires you to install an app either on your laptop or your mobile device. The reason why we have two choices is that sometimes your device may not be on the same network as the ViewSonic display. If your device is not on the same network, you need to cast using the web portal. If your device is on the same network, you should use the app because the app is going to give you better performance. So that's step one, is to get the app or go to the website. Next, you're going to see here we have options for display code or one-time passwords. Let's go over here and let's connect the laptop. It's very easy. So I'm going to open up the AirSync Sender app. It's already installed on my laptop. You'll notice that I can type in the display code and the password. There's also a device list option. The device list is a little faster because I can just click that and see any devices that are already on my network. Now you might wonder which device is which. Well, here in the AirSync app on the top right, it's telling me that this is 87645. And if I look here in my list, I have 87645. I'm gonna choose next. And then I have the option to share or receive. Again, this is an all-in-one solution. So maybe you wanna present your ViewSonic display to your device. You would choose the receive option. If you want to present your device to the ViewSonic, then you're gonna choose the share option. So we're gonna go ahead and choose share because we're gonna use this like a projector. This little notification will pop up. This is just giving permission for the device that's casting to be approved. So we're gonna click accept here. Now, over here on my laptop, it's gonna give me the choice to share my entire screen, a specific window, or use what's called screen extension. This is if you would want to run, say, like extended desktop. We're just gonna share our entire screen here. Note also, you can share your computer audio. And then you're gonna see here that my laptop instantly starts mirroring to the ViewSonic display. Now this window that's open that you see here, this is the AirSync Sender app. So if you close that window, it will disconnect everything. So normally you would just minimize this or hide it so it's out of the way, and then you can start showing what's on your laptop. But I want you to notice something about this screen. See here where it says allow touchback? If you're using a ViewSonic display that's interactive and you're connecting, say, your MacBook, your Windows laptop, you can actually enable touchback on the screen. Let me demonstrate. So you'll notice that if I touch right now, nothing happens to my computer. But if I come over here and I turn on the allow touchback option, now I'm gonna be able to come over here and I can interact. For example, I could open up my whiteboard program if I wanted to. And you'll see here that if I touch, it's going to respond to the touch. Now, again, this is unique to MacBook and Windows laptops. If I'm using an iPad or an Android device, unfortunately, you don't have the ability to use touchback, but you can still cast and present. Now, at any time, I can disconnect. All I need to do is either press the stop button here in the middle, or I can go back to my AirSync app and I can hit the stop button. You also have a pause button here. This is helpful as if you're presenting or projecting and you wanna freeze your screen or you wanna pause what you're on, you can simply click the pause button. This will lock the screen. So this allows you then to do some work over here if you would like to, maybe check your email or do something. And then all you have to do is come back and click that pause button again, and then it will resume the live feed. Again, when you're finished, we're just gonna hit the X button and it's gonna close us out, and you'll see it takes us back to the AirSync app. Now, we're not gonna have time to get into all the details and features, so be sure to watch our other videos about the AirSync app, but I'll just give you a quick preview. AirSync has some cool features like moderator mode. Moderator mode actually is like a waiting room, so you can have various devices sitting here waiting to be approved, so you can instantly have those screens come in, as well as having multiple screens present. You'll see down here in the bottom left, there's this settings section. The settings section lets us turn on things like casting out to devices. So again, if I wanted to present my ViewSonic out to multiple laptops or other devices, I can do that, but I have to turn it on here. So we have a video about that. We also have the ability to group multiple ViewSonic displays together. So if you're wanting to show this display on other displays in your room without using cables, you can use AirSync to do that. But to get started, open the AirSync app, make sure you have the app installed on your laptop, and to get more information about those other features, be sure to watch our other videos about AirSync.